Alrighty, nice break by Cliff. I started putting a star by the player who broke, so we'll know who broke this rack. Cliff Joyner has the star by his name. That's what that signifies. Semi-final action you're watching here from the Green Room in Jackson, Mississippi. Great pool room, a lot of action over here always. great little tournament. 18 players in the one pocket. Looks like we're going to end up with about 33 or 4 in the nine ball. Pretty crazy. More money added to this tournament this weekend than any tournament anywhere for this weekend. 33 players. Rob with a little rub on the one ball. No, he missed it on the way in. Yeah, you do not want to get into a little button game with Cliff Joyner. Players are woofing it up in the background here.
What, yesterday or today? Zero today. Yesterday I played two. Lost them both.
Well, this rack here is turning into some strategery. Well, I bet Rob wishes he would went over and looked at that seven ball now and seen if it was frozen up. This Cliff didn't catch a rail afterwards. It didn't look like that cue ball caught the top rail anyway. It's a good shot. Rob kind of unfolded the stack a little there. Okay.
7 this time. Move to 7 of them. Keep sleeping.
He's going right in the dream. Bummer. Well, Rob is going the wrong way here. And Cliff Joyner. Chance to possibly even just close this game out. Nice touch. He's got the 14 here, and he may just put some. Yeah. Well, before I could even suggest what he might be doing, he fired it, and this should be it. Cliff Joyner and Stony Stone Finals. Wait a minute. Back up. That's right. You know what? They're not lagging. Not lagging. That's weird. They're supposed to lag right now. Rob gets his break off. Yeah, my bad. I was thinking that Cliff had won the first game and that was it. So, definitely not it. The last rack. And this is Rob's break. Fact that they were supposed to lag just came up, and they're starting it over with the lag, and it's going to be Rob's break. All right. Well, somebody must have snapped too there. And caught the no lag there. Turns out Rob's breaking anyway. And we start it over. Rack number three.
Thank you. Guy really didn't have to scratch from there. Guy really didn't have to scratch from there, did he?
Thank you.
It's still a game. Still plenty close from here. Take a few innings to win this game. Yeah, hey guys, it's Luke here, back again. So I'm gonna sweat the end of this match. Yeah, that was a wild shot though, Ronnie. All those balls up table. Kinda makes for I don't know. A lot of times when I see the balls up table like that, some days frustrates me. I don't know if that's what's going on or not. I haven't been watching 100%. Trying to get this players auction going here. Be nice. Which will happen after this match is over. Yeah, I don't know if... A lot of options in these situations a lot of times. Looks like he missed that ball. One pocket just requires so much patience when there's so many things going on. You can drive a person through the roof. Got a great field here, though. A lot of good players. Well, obviously, world champion players. We're watching a pair of world champions here. Good shot, Rob. Rob might want to keep in mind. Ball's coming up on the spot here. Makes this shot here a little different. He'd like to play shape here, but that ball on the spot. Oh, okay, he's putting the cue ball back. What a nice shot. Unfortunately for Rob, the ball fell. He'd have been a very happy man if the ball would have just laid up in the pocket or somewhere nearby. Didn't happen. Back to the grind it is. Cliff comes out shooting there. Tough action. Very tough. Very tough shot he just made there to go right by the one. Most people can't even shoot it. It's just too close to the one. And there's no reason not to kick at this ball if you think you can get it close to your pocket. And if he gives up the cross corner here, Rob's going to be happy. Be looking at something offensive. Right now, I get the feeling that... Very well hit ball there. Get the feeling if Rob gets a few shots here, he's going to get a lot more comfortable than if he just stares at the end rail for the rest of the match. That's my feelings on the matter. He is an incredibly disciplined champion, though. So, there you have it. Looks like he's ready for a long match. Long game. What? Yeah. Rob executing the textbook two-railer. Forcing a defensive shot. I think Rob's happy to see that there. Not as static, but this open those balls up. He's got a banking lane now. Whether or not he wants to fool with the seven ball or not, I don't know. Or the two rather on the two, both look real touchy to me. I have a two brother on the seven. Yeah, very well. Hit ball there again. Rob. And he's back in the match. Don't really know what he's got to try and play shape on here. Cinch the 7 in. Have a look at the end game. Okay, the 3-reeler did go there. Doing something with the 5 here. Looks like they might just be in a safety battle. Ball positioning battle here. Wow, he shot. It's free, but the 5's trickled out. Rob's gonna have a shot at this one, I'm sure. In the pocket. This ball could come out. Very tough to get out from the look of it, but Cliff may not even fool with it, just to avoid any crazy scratch or something odd happening. Give him shape on the ball though. Oh, I don't know if this is any good. Turned out really good. Good chance Cliff will shoot this 14 and stick the cue ball on the 15. Okay, you can see this ball in the spot. There's a fine save. Yeah, that's a touchy shot in this situation here. Thank you. gotten jacked up on this Bubs. So if he shoots over here, there's a good chance Cliff's gonna do something with the 11. May cut at it or cross bank it. Like, more than likely he'll cross bank this ball, I'd say. And I think he just felt more comfortable with the safety. Well, Rob got a little carried away there, I think. He tried to shoot. I like to shoot at that shot myself, too. When I do, there's always someone on the rail who'll comment how wild it was. I'm not sure if it was or wasn't. It's a very tough shot to execute, but to make the ball, but it's not so hard to execute to get the ball on your side. And, this isn't bad here either, kicking at this ball. But it's somewhat safe. Especially coming off the second rail there. Tough play here. They both really look like they're at home though. Like they're in their living room. Ready for a bag of popcorn. So I guess he's gonna try and trickle the cue ball behind the 14 here if he's looking at that 10. Wow, it looks like he might be doing something radical there. Looking at something radical. Just try and force this 14 off the 10, 12 down there. That'd be a heck of a shot to see. Okay. Looked at a simple shot. Often enough, simple shots are all it takes to get the job done. My experience, just as often. Taking a few chances. A little complicated, or I should say, getting a little complicated with things. Often enough will blow up. So we got the balls back down table now. I believe Cliff can shoot at this ball if he wants to. I mean, I've seen him shoot at it plenty of times. But he may just favor his position. We'll see. Yeah, it looks like he's going to have a shot at it. Play the cue ball back in the general direction where it's at. Yeah. Good speed.
They're battling it out here, aren't they, Luke?
Yeah, down to the last two. And they're really moving the balls around. You know, 1 minute they're shooting freely, the next they play 17 safeties. It's interesting to watch. Especially when...
Well, it's a big game. I can't remember the exact payouts for second and third, but I think it's a pretty decent swing, maybe $300 or $400. First is $1,400. Yeah, do you remember what second and third were?
I think it was 14, I want to say 6 and 4.
I think you're right.
Wow, what a shot. And this cue ball is going to, looks like it's going to die and hold in the corner. But
no, it's goners.
It's gone. Yeah.
Wow.
Wow, did he hit that ball incredible or what? All right.
So where does that put us at?
Saez, my 5 and Cliff at 6 still. All three balls are going to come up and... Or the two we made and
one's
the one
down.
He owes.
Yeah.
So. Well, there's a Cliff joiner. Hand shot for you. He's putting himself in a situation here, though. He's got to figure out how to move these balls without giving up an aggressive shot. It's not that hard, but there's a lot of two railers or one railers that can pop up right here. Yeah, so he went up table with it.
That was a great cut.
On the 11, yeah.
Yeah, on that last ball, yeah.
But right here, Saez is in the game. I mean, he can... one shot, one inning. He can be out here easy. Exciting stuff. He wants to shoot this fly ball so bad too, Ray. Yeah.
Wow, that was looking real good for a second there.
He hit that ball. Yeah. Surprised he gave him that ball there. Being it's Cliff Joyner, though, it must have made a lot of sense. I think we're going to see Cliff shoot at this cross corner here.
Yeah, definitely. Well, I thought I'd warm up a little bit on the nine-ball tournament. We've got about 30, I think 35 players total. They're about to get rolling, and which they need to do pretty quick.
Right, after this game, right?
Yeah, but yeah. My only mistake was I decided to warm up with Jason Evans, and, and I haven't been shooting a whole lot.
Yeah, see.
No, oh, I got to run right now.
Yep,
right back.
There we are. Good shooting, good Cliff.
Awesome.
Fun.
Yeah, thanks, Luke. Yeah. Cliff Joyner finishes it off 8-6 over Rob Saez, and he'll move into the finals. It's going to be Cliff Joyner and Stony Stone. Yep. Awesome. This is going to be a great finals. I think we're going to do the players auction before the finals, though, so stay tuned, folks. We'll be back here shortly.
Right now, you got a couple minutes. Looks like we got about 35, 30.